My name is Jim Duncan, and I am a father, a husband, and a person of faith. To know me, you have to know my story. This is why I run. My father was raised in Anderson, South Carolina. When he was a young man, he joined the Navy to fight in World War II. He, like many others at the time, wanted to serve humbly and with honor for this great nation. But as fate would have it, his ship was sunk off the coast of Casablanca in the invasion of North Africa. He survived, but 59 out of 120 of his shipmates gave their lives for freedom. As the war was ending, he married my mom. After the war, my father joined the New York City Police Department. At first, we lived in the projects, but my parents believed in a future for their children, working hard and making sacrifices. I remember their pride, the excitement when we moved from the projects into a new home. Our big summer vacations were our annual trips to Anderson, South Carolina to visit my grandparents. My grandfather was a World War I veteran, and Granny, who could not read or write, was very special, and she made the best biscuits in the world. These trips were the most exciting and enriching experiences and the best memories of my childhood. The South is my home. I was the first person in my family to attend college. My parents made many sacrifices in order for me to receive an education. They did not see this as a burden, but simply what was expected. After college, I joined the National Guard, doing my basic training and AIT at Fort Jackson, South Carolina. Eventually, my career led me to the burgeoning high-tech equipment leasing business. I was very fortunate to be part of a team where I grew as a businessman and as a person. Once again, my life was blessed. Eventually, my wife and I moved to Connecticut, bought a house, and began to raise a family. I was doing well. I was living the American dream. One day, I stopped by my old high school, an all-boys Catholic school, St. Raymond's. That day took our great life to another level and closer to God. Many of these young men became part of our family. I experienced firsthand the failure of the progressive policies and witnessed how these policies destroyed the family unit. I knew that things were headed in the wrong direction. Over the next 20 years, we took matters in our own hands. We offered our love and our home to these young men. I was so inspired and touched by working with these young men that it gave back to us 100 times more than what we put in. I learned that responsibility for a better society, that responsibility is ours. When I retired, and I like to say refocused, we moved to North Carolina because I knew it was where I belonged and I wanted to call it home. I was ready to relax, play golf, and enjoy life. But in January of 2010, when President Obama gave his State of the Union speech and humiliated the Supreme Court, I knew I had to get involved. This was my tipping point. I rolled up my sleeves and volunteered with the local Republican Party. Together, we grew our membership. We spread the word with local residents about how conservative policies could improve their lives. We grew new volunteers and helped to elect new candidates in the county. Eventually, I was honored to serve as chairman of the Chatham County Republican Party. Today, I am running because I want to serve. I have represented the interests of others my entire life. I am running to take your voice to Washington, D.C., not to bring Washington, D.C.'s voice to you. My dad told me as a child that the men on his ship died so that I could live out my dreams. I am running to give that same path of opportunity to others that was paved for me. Working hard, building a family, raising the bar, exploring new opportunities, and giving back. This is the American way. I am running because I owe it to the next generation to show them what principled leadership and conviction looks like. I am running to have the honor of serving you and your family. It's time to stand up for American principles. Please join our team. Let's build something new and exciting in the 2nd District. I'm Jim Duncan, and I approve this message. paid for by Jim for NC Committee.